Thursday night. Hopefully, y'all got a look at the full moon. Did you get a look, Nice?
Did not.
Neither did I. After all my talk about going out to see it. Got a little bit of a Guy Clark on my head here. Denise and I went up to Rockport Harbor last weekend for a few days and took a ride out in an old boat. Made me think of old boat building days. But it's time for change. I'm tired of the same old same. Same old words, the same old lines. Same old songs with the same old rhyme. Days, endless days. Going in and out like the waves. I got boards to bend, I got planks to nail. Charts to make, I got seas to sail. I'm gonna build me a boat, these two hands be. Fine curse of noble plans, let the chips fall where they will. I got boats to build. It's alumni weekend at Fenn, so I'd like to, any alumni that are out there hanging out tonight, appreciate it. Recently got a couple of cool wood shop stories from my days as a wood shop teacher. Brian Burns' dad was telling me that Brian, working down there at J.P. Morgan, still has his shaker desk in his bed. Trotsky assures me that his rowboat he made 20 years ago is still floating. As with Andres, whoever else, you know. You know, sails are like wings, and the wind can make them sing. You got songs of love, you got songs of hope, songs to keep your dreams afloat. I'm gonna build me a boat with these two hands be. Fine curves and noble plans, let the chips fall where they will. Well, I got boats to build. Well, shores and the shores, that's where I'm heading for. I got the stars to light my way, sailing to a brand new day. I'm gonna build me a boat with these two hands be. Fine curves from noble plans, let the chips fall where they will. Let the chips fall where they will. I got boats to build. All right.
Happy Thursday to my cousin Jerry.
Oh, Jerry, how are you?
Chris Snell is bright and early.
Bright and early, man, Chris. This doesn't seem right. Remember, you were embarrassing him by talking about him in the thread last week.
Becky Valentine says,
hello. Hey, Becky, how are you doing? I should do my Becky Valentine's. Wasn't she the one that weren't you requesting Jim Croce last week, Becky? And you were stumping me, you know.
Back from Maine.
Oh, Jack. I'll do a Jack song right now.
Happy Thursday to Dan
Healy. And Dan Healy, of course.
And Bill Gibson. He says you sound much better.
Oh, do I look better, Bill? I love Bill. Bill's one of the only people that gives me the honest, unvarnished truth, you know. You sound like shit tonight, you know, so whatever. But, I did play with the mic a little bit more tonight, Bill. So hopefully it's working. But all right, well, here we go. Jack McGuire, I haven't seen you in a while. So here's the song we learned for Jack when his wife Linda was dealing with her cancer. She did it very bravely. May God's blessings keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others, let others do for you. And will you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung? Will you stay forever young? Forever young. Forever young. Won't you stay forever young? May you grow up to be righteous. May you grow up to be true. Will you always do for others and let others do for you? May you always be courageous, grow upright and be strong. May you stay forever young, forever young. Yeah, forever young. May you stay forever young.
So Jack, this last verse, I always think of my mother because my mother worked at the wool shop in Concord, down Concord Center, then later on at Needle Arts in West Concord. And I don't think I ever saw my mother just sitting down. You know? I could be in the middle of a football game, she could be at a wrestling match of mine, look up in the stands, there's my mother knitting something, telling me not to show off or whatever.
May your hands always be busy. May your feet always be swift. May you build a strong foundation when the winds of change you shift. May your heart always be joyful. Will your song always be sung? And may you stay forever young. Forever young. Forever young. And may you stay forever young.
More hellos. John O'Connell.
Hey, John O'Connell. John O'Connell's dad was the icon of Concord. He was Coach O'Connell, my old gym teacher. And back in the 70s at CC, we used to have open gym classes and stuff. And so me and Tortorella and Lana and Muskie and Hardy, we'd go down to the bowling alley and have breakfast with Coach O'Connell before we bowled a few strings, which counted as gym credit. Oh, hey, Barbara.
And J.B. Henderson.
J.B.
Just tuning in with the Beacon Hill gang, me and Pat Myra. And
oh, my God, because
Sarah Robertson.
Yeah, the Fenn folks were saying that I had to do a few songs just for Fenn people because it was alumni weekend. They wanted to do me to do some kind of concert or something, so I said I'd do something. So know what I'll do, because Pat Myra's there. JB, I was never had him in class. I think he was in honors English, but Pat Mara, he's out there. He had me for my my first year teaching English, and I was a shop teacher for 10 years, and they gave me one class of 14 year old boys to teach English, and my theme had to be man's quest for paradise. So I wasn't that successful with that, but every Friday morning would actually just sing this song. It's called Paradise. It's that way I was able to, in a very weekly way, explore the theme of paradise, even though this was, ironically, the loss of paradise.
Thank you. Day when I was a child and my family were traveling to Western Kentucky where my parents were born. It's a backwards old town and it's often remembered. There's so many times that its memories are warm. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River, where paradise lay. Sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Well, sometime we travel on down the Green River to an abandoned old prison where paradise lay. Yeah, they asked me like snakes and we'd shoot off our pistols, but empty pop bottles was all that we'd kill. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lay. Sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Well, the coal company came, had the world's biggest shovel. They tortured the timber, they stripped all the land. Dug for their coal till their load was forgotten. They wrote it all down as the progress of man. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lay. Sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. When I die, let my ashes flow down the Green River. Let my soul run on up to the Rochester Dam. I'll be halfway to heaven with paradise waiting 5 miles away from wherever I am. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lay. Sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County, down by the Green River where paradise lay. Sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. Well, it's hauled it all. I was just over hat racks before this. And thank God. I hope he's not watching me play the harmonica.
Cindy Hartigan just popped on. Just she only has a minute, but I'm so happy it was that song.
Oh, really? Yeah. It'll be another good Cindy song. Cause she can send along one I might know. That's what I'm trying to think of, a camp song, you know. What?
There's 8,000 camps.
Oh, I know, but yeah, that's the problem. It's like when I go to the, remember when I used to go to the video store?
Well, Mike Stevens said, is this a night for protest songs? Change is going to come.
All right, Mike. Come gather around, people, wherever you're all. And admit that the waters around you have grown, and accept it that soon you'll be drenched to the bone. If your time to you is worth saving, yeah, you better start swimming or you'll sink like a stone. For the times they are changing. Come mothers and fathers, brothers throughout the land. And don't criticize what you can't understand. Your sons and your daughters are beyond your command. And the order is rapidly fading. Please get out of the new one if you can lend a hand. For the times they are changing. Come writers and critics who prophesize with your pen. And keep your eyes wide, the chance won't come again. And don't speak too soon, for the wheel's still in spin. And there's no telling who that it's naming. And the loser now will be later to win. For the times they are a-changing.
Looking in my head, where else we got?
Come senators, congressmen, please heed the call. Don't stand in the doorway, don't block up the hall. Though he who gets hurt will be he who has stalled. The old road is rapidly changing. Please get out of the new one if you can lend your hand. For the times they are a-changing. Yes, the times they are a-changing.
Done that one a long time. Thank you, Mike. Hey, Skeeter. Denise was looking at old CB, Honda CB motorcycles today on Facebook. Said she found a good one.
JB Henderson.
Yeah?
It's saying, Downeaster Alexa for the nautical theme we got going on.
Oh.
You know that?
No. I should know that. That's.
I told you to learn that, right? I'm a big fan.
Yes. Billy Joel's voice and mine aren't like the.
His voice was like Billy Joel. We wouldn't be living in Maine. Or
no, no, we'd be hanging out in Long Island Sound right now. I wouldn't call it a nautical theme either. JB, I think. No, he said to keep up the nautical theme. I think I only did one sea song.
Maybe they have a nautical theme going on in Boston. Maybe he's not talking about you.
Oh, okay. Let me see. What would be a good nautical theme song right now?
Gideon Brown.
Or Gideon Brown. We could. Get Tyler Davis out of the way too. You know, he's in here. He's a Gideon Brown fan. I don't know if you're a great Big C fan, JB, but we certainly are. He should be. It's way better than Down East Alexa. Got a little more grit in the teeth there.
He said the nautical theme was about your anchor and harpoon on your
anchor. Oh, that's right.
The anchor behind you.
Yeah, you got me there, JB. Well, show him the octopuses. Well, look at this, JB. See if we can do it.
All right. Okay.
We only have one cable, so we can't play around with it that much. Emma, drew that for me. Let's see.
Oh, Gideon lived across the bay. He's getting older now. His boat was big and strong and bold. It had a stalwart bow. My father's boat was second hand, one someone used before. And after every fishing trip, my father always swore, someday he'd save enough, go to St. John Town, buy himself a big new boat like Gideon Brown. It'll punch ahead in any gale, ride the fishing ground. I often thought how proud I'd be in a boat like Gideon Brown, boat like Gideon Brown. Yeah, the Federation came around. Days of old age pensions. Son, I'm saving every cent. This you must not mention. Save the baby bonus too. Things just might turn around. We'll save enough to buy a boat. A boat like Gideon Brown. It'll punch ahead in any gale. Ride the fishing ground. I often thought how proud I'd be in a boat like Gideon Brown. A boat like Gideon Brown. Many years have come and gone. Dad begun to fade. He didn't talk of boats that much. Said, son, I'm afraid. If things don't soon improve, I'll soon be underground. We'll never get to see ourselves in a boat like Gideon Brown. It'll punch ahead in any gale. Ride the fishing ground. I often thought how proud I'd be in a boat like Gideon Brown. A boat like Gideon Brown. Well, I sat and held his hand one day. Said, son, the policy. The insurance is all in your name. You're the beneficiary. When I'm dead, they'll pay you off. Go to St. John Town. Buy yourself a big new boat. A boat like Gideon Brown. It'll punch ahead in any gale. Ride the fishing ground. I often thought how proud I'd be in a boat like Gideon Brown. It'll punch ahead in any gale. Ride the fishing ground. I often thought how proud I'd be. Often thought how proud I'd be. Often thought how proud I'd be in a boat like Gideon Brown. A boat like Gideon Brown. And in a boat like Gideon Brown. Oh, wow. That's cool.
Heard her in ages.
Yeah.
She loves when you do these, Fitzy.
Well, thank you for tuning in. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in.
So, Bill Gibson wants you to tell everybody about your beautiful guitar.
This beautiful guitar?
And then he said, awesome sailors for trailer rent.
sailors for trailer rent. Well, remember, what was it? Some 20 years ago, a little more than 20 years ago, maybe. It was the day before St. Patrick's Day. And this guitar right there was the guitar I was using. Beautiful old Goodall. And I was playing at a senior citizen home. I was playing outside in a patio or something. And as I walked away, I threw my guitar over my shoulder to look like Woody Guthrie.
With a strap.
With a strap on, yes. Yes, I thought the strap was on. So that guitar broke into about 1 million pieces. So I went down to... where did we go? I don't figure where we went, but anyway. This was like an old J200 Gibson. Cost way more money than we had, didn't it? So I had this for a long time, but it too fell off the wall once. The kids were doing flips on the couch. So I took it into the shop in the Fen. I had like 15 kids all holding their little fingers all the way around this thing. I told them if they moved, they were going to fail shop. So put it all back together with the help of Tom Cummings. The whole back has fallen off before, too.
Did your daughter do the artwork?
I had my daughter do the artwork. Kaylee did this. Everybody thinks this is like Chinese or something, but it actually just says Fitz. And some people think it's very violent, but I guess harpoons and sperm whales, you know. So that's kind of the story. I usually play this one. It's a sweet little guitar. This was D.A. Rutter's. Those of you might remember D.A. from Fen. His mom gave me that after he died. And it gets me a little weepy every time I play it, but it's a beautiful guitar.
Got another request here.
Yeah, what's that?
Nancy Troutman.
Quit talking. Oh, hey, Nancy.
Patty West?
No, I don't know it.
I think that's a sea song. All right, well, you can do Sailors for Trailer Rent.
I'll tell you, here you go, Bill. Sailors for Trailer Rent, here we go. Say hey to Eric and Lars. Remember the time Eric was working over here when we first bought the house? Another one of my Fenn students. You know. No, he remember when he thought the doll on the
Oh, that's right.
We had a doll hanging on the rail of the sun deck, and Eric thought it was a real baby, and he went running over to save it. You know? Anyway, here we go, a little Roger Miller. Trailers for sailorette, room to let 50 cents, no phone, no pool, no bed. Ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys an 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. Third boxcar, midnight train, destination Bangor, Maine. Old worn out coat and shoes. I don't pay no union dues. I smoke old stogies I have found. Short but not too big around. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road. I know every engineer and every train, all of their children and all of their names, and every handout in every town. Heavy lock, chain lock, no one's around to sing. Trailers for sailorette, room to let 50 cents. No phone, no pool, no pets. I ain't got no cigarettes, but 2 hours of pushing broom buys an 8x12 4-bedroom. I'm a man of means by no means, king of the road, king of the road, king of the road.
Tyler Davis has a great request.
What's that?
Barrett's Privateers.
Oh, there we go. We can keep this. You'd like this one, Nancy. It's hard to do alone. Maybe Denise will help me. Anyway, well, if you're out there and you feel like saying it, just, you know, say, God damn them all. I mean, that's the only chorus you need to know. Sorry, my computer is dinging over there. It's funny to sing an old sea song and have my computer dinging in the background. Oh, the year was 1778. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. And a letter of marque come from the king to the scummiest vessel I've ever seen. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateer. Hi, Euclid Barry, cried the town. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. Oh, 20 brave men, all fishermen, who would make for him the Antelope's crew. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateers. On the king's birthday, they set to sea. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. Here in 91 days to Montego Bay, bumping like a madman all the way. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateers. On the king's birthday we sailed again. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. And a bloody great Yankee ho in sight, with our cracked 9-pounder we made to fight. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateers. How the Yankee lay low down with gold. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. She was broad and fat and loose in the stays. To catch her took the antelope 2 whole days. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier. The last to bear its privateers.
Probably have a halftime here, you know, but...
Oh, at length we stood 2 cables away. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. A crack 9-pounder made an awful din. With 1 fat ball, the Yanks stove us in. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier. The last to bear its privateers. How the antelope shook and she pitched on her side. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. Little Barrett was smashed like a bowl of eggs. The main trunk carried off both my legs. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier. The last to bear its privateers. Well, here I am in my 23rd year. I wish I was in Sherbrooke now. It's been 6 years since I sailed away. I just made Halifax yesterday. God damn them all. I was told we'd cruise the seas for American gold. Fire no guns and we'd shed no tears. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateers. I'm a broken man on a Halifax pier, the last to bear its privateers.
Said that was a good chorus for the debate, maybe.
Oh, yes. God damn them all. That's a great song. I mean, that God damn them all, man. That. I was talking to the head of a very fancy private school once, and he lived near the campus, and so I asked him how close to the campus did he live, and he said, at least 20 the hell with them's away. My hair? I was walking around this morning and Denise said, you know your sweater's on backwards. I was like,
inside out.
Inside out. I said, it can't be. I had it on like this yesterday. But, let me see. Should I do my woman song?
Your woman.
Oh, I'm not doing the woman song, am I? But last week we had like a little 70s fest. I didn't mean to. And Helen Reddy died yesterday. She was always being played in our house. And Denise was regaling me with stories of her brothers. She said she even had a tape recording of her brother Kevin singing a Helen Reddy song in the shower, which I would pay so much money.
And then he'd need more years of therapy.
So about 4 o'clock this afternoon, Denise said, you have to learn, what's the name of the song? Delta Dawn. So this is our tribute to Helen Reddy. And if Hillary Taylor is out there, yes, Denise actually made cue cards. Can I show the people one of the cue cards?
Huh? I haven't seen her yet.
So I guess I can't screw up, except I'll probably forget the tune, you know. But all my Fenn students, you might have missed the old Helen Reddy days, but you know.
Hillary Taylor,
here we go. Oh, let's see. There you go, Hillary. My 70s set. I was hanging out with Wally last night, and...
It is a Tanya Tucker song.
It's a Tanya... Oh, is it, really?
Yeah, but Helen Reddy.
Yeah, you know.
Oh, Delta Dawn, what's that flower you got on? Could it be a faded rose in days gone by? And did I hear you say you'd be meeting them here today to take you to that great mansion in the sky?
The great big by and by. Now you gotta show me this stuff now.
She's 41 and her daddy still calls her baby. Yeah, and all the folks round Brownsville call her crazy. Cause she walks downtown with a suitcase in her hand. Yeah, looking for a mysterious dark-haired man.
I like these lines.
In her younger days they called her Delta Dawn. Yeah, the prettiest woman you ever laid eyes on. Then a man of low degree stood by her side, and he promised her he'd have her for his bride. Yeah, Delta.
Oh no, then they go up like this, don't they?
Oh, Delta Dawn, what's that flower you got on? Could it be a faded rose in days gone by? And did I hear say she was meeting you here today to take you to his mansion in the sky? Will that circle be unbroken? By and by, Lord, by and by, there's a bitter home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Said Undertaker, 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 please drive slow. His body at your holding, hey, we hey, see her go. Yeah, Delta Dawn, what's that flower you got on? Could it be a faded rose days gone by? And did I hear you say you'd be meeting him here today to take you to that sweet by and by? Yeah, to take you to that mansion in the sky.
What?
Auto-correcting. He says, you sound like you might be able to model. And then he said it again, whoops, model, auto-correct. I'm trying to say yodel.
Yodel.
You do a yodeling song.
Oh yeah, well, I'll do a yodeling song. I'll do a yodeling song I wrote here. I'm a horrible yodeler, but... This will be my moon song. Oh, did they? You'd have to be pretty forgiving. It was 3 o'clock when Denise told me I had to learn it, you know, so. Well, this is right.
Well, the stars are all pinpricks tonight, and the moon is a pebble of light. Well, I look at the sky, keep wondering why I chose the cowboy's life. I had a good job in Flint making cars. I had a habit of hanging in bars. Well, I learned every week I could blow all my pay. Now all I count is the stars. Yodely, yodeloo, yodely, yodeloo, singing
he's cowboy blue. Yeah, I came here to find a big sky and live close to the sweet by and by. Hell on her in top was barely enough. The boss said to give me a try. Well, that's been 32 years or so that I came here to Idaho. Yeah, I ruined the life of a wonderful wife, but that was so damn long ago. Yodely, yodeloo, yodely, yodeloo, singing this cowboy blue. Well, high boots are better than shoes, and old songs is better than news. And this high mountain pasture's my final hereafter, to sing you these cowboy blues. Here no one can call me a liar. Well, I'm sitting out here by the fire, just me and my cattle, and me and my saddle, and 85 head of cattle, gloves and fence poles and barbed wire. Yodelay, yodeloo, yodelay, yodeloo, singing this cowboy blue. Yodeloo, 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 yodeloo. Singing this cowboy blue. Wrote that song for the McNamaras when they moved out to Idaho.
Hillary's got a request.
Is it?
Harvest Moon.
Oh.
You gotta do Harvest Moon tonight, right?
Yeah, the night was mighty dark and the stars could see. The moon refused to shine. Couple sitting underneath a willow tree for love, they pine. Little maid's afraid of darkness, she says, I guess I'll go. Boy begins to cry, looks up at the sky, sings the moon his little tale of woe. Shine on, harvest moon, up in the sky. Well, I ain't had no love since January, February, June, or July. Springtime's not the time to stay inside and swoon. So shine on, harvest moon, for me and my gal.
I know you meant a Neil Young Harvest Moon.
He said, well, that's not what I was thinking.
Here's a song about going to the moon, a song I didn't know last week, but I know this week. Let me see.
Right. Say hi to Dan Gannon.
Danny Gannon!
He said she still fondly picture your mom getting away.
Is it Dan or Beth?
Dan.
Oh, Dan's on. Good.
Beth's Facebook page.
Remember? Danny Gannon is the one who shoots the cannon in the swamp. See you later, Danny Gannon, who's the one who shoots the cannon in the swamp. See, Dan, I don't forget many things, you know. I forget to call you on your birthday. That's about it.
Speaking of birthdays, sing happy.
I will. I got to do my Neil Young song, though. I thought somebody would ask for Harvest Moon, because I was asking Emma what her favorite Neil Young song was, and she said it was Harvest Moon. And... Well, I dreamed I saw the knights in armor coming, saying something about a queen. There were peasants singing and drummers drumming, and the archer split the tree. There was a fanfare blowing in my head, it was floating on the breeze.
Look at Mother Nature on the run in the 1970s. Oh, look at Mother Nature on the run in the 1970s. I was lying in a burned out basement with a full moon in my eye. I was hoping for a replacement when the sun burst through the sky. There was a song playing in my head and I felt like getting high. Thinking about what a friend had said, I was hoping it was a lie. Yeah, thinking about what a friend had said, I was hoping it was a lie.
See, this is almost a moon song, Hillary, because we're gonna go up in a spaceship, so.
Well, I dreamed I saw the silver spaceship flying in the yellow haze of the sun. There were children crying and colors flying all around the chosen one. All in a dream, all in a dream, the loading begun. Flying Mother Nature's silver seed to a new home in the sun. Flying Mother Nature's silver seed to a new
Now I can let it be said that I sang a Neil Young song and didn't screw up the words.
Right.
It was funny. Last time when I was talking with Wally, he was asking me how the live streams are going. I said, oh, they're good. I said, you know, I'm trying to learn some more modern songs. So I named a bunch of songs that I had learned. And he goes, those are all from the 1970s. I'm like, yeah, I know. He goes, That's not very modern. I thought it was pretty modern.
50 years ago.
Well, you put it that way. We had a kid get up at Fenn one day, and this last year, before all the COVID stuff, and they're doing electric guitar solo, and Richard Keller, and he's so cute. He gets up there, hooks up his electric guitar, and he's like, here's a song. It's an old song, you might not know. It's from the 1900s by... Van Halen.
We're all getting old.
But this is a Jim Croce song. I think Becky Valentine asked for a bit Jim Croce last week. And...
doesn't matter that your wife's been asking for decades.
So I learned this from my wife. That's my first time singing it. And Hillary knows that whenever I sing a song the first time live, there's always interesting twists of lyrical wonder going on. Like the pine tree to light in the winding road, I got a name, I got a name. Like the singing bird or the croaking toad, I got a name, I got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did, but I'm living the dream that he had, that he kept hid. Sorry, here we go. Taking me down the highway, rolling me down the highway. What do I say now?
Rolling ahead.
Rolling ahead so life won't pass me by. So it's like self-fulfilling, because I know when I do the first one, I get all, my head is swimming with a million things, you know? Like the north wind whistling down the sky, I got a song, I got a song. Like the whippoorwill of the baby's cry, I got a song, I got a song. And I'll carry it with me and I'll sing it loud. If it takes me nowhere, I'll go there proud. Well, moving me down the highway, taking me down the highway, leaving alone. What is it?
I don't even know.
Jeez. It's that last little, like living the dream, so living the dream, so life won't pass me by. Well, I know even Wally knew all the words to this song last night. Like the fool I am, this is a good verse for me. Like the fool I am and I'll always be, I got a dream, I got a dream. They can change their mind, but they can't change me. I got a dream, I got a dream. Oh, I could share it if you want me to. If you're going my way, I'll go with you. Now they're gonna do my part, I screw up. Moving me down the highway, taking me down the highway, living my life, living my dreams, so life won't pass me by. Oh, what a butcher job.
Yes.
Well, thank you. You know. Yes, it's nice to have a supportive wife. You know. Well.
Jamie Henderson was asking for Gone to Carolina. You don't know that one.
No, I did learn what I learned.
My brother was saying, is Carefree Highway in the repertoire?
No. See, that's the problem when you start doing 70 songs, and people think you know a lot of songs people know. I can do an old James.
Oh, Becky said thank you anyway.
Okay, don't worry, Becky. It'll be much better like 2 weeks from now. Once it's stuck in my head. There is a young cowboy, he lives on the range. His horse and his cattle are his only companions. But he works in the saddle and he sleeps in the canyons, waiting for summer, his pastures to change. And as the moon rises, he sits by his fire, thinking about women and glasses of beer, closing his eyes as the doggies retire, sings out a song which is soft but it's clear, as if maybe someone might hear. So good night, you moonlight ladies, rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down in my dream and rock-a-bye, sweet baby James. Well, the 1st of December was covered with snow, and so was the turnpike from Stockbridge to Boston. And the Berkshire seemed dreamlike on account of that frosting. But 10 miles behind me, 10,000 more to go, there's a song they sing when they take to the highway, song they sing when they take to the sea,
song they sing of their home in the sky. You can believe it if it helps you to sleep. Singing works just fine for me. So good night, you moonlight ladies, rocked by sweet baby James. Deep greens and blues are the colors I choose. Won't you let me go down in my dreams and rock by sweet baby James. Rock-a-bye, sweet baby Jane. Let me see. Oh, there we go. For Jimmy and Kevin, how many brother-in-laws do I have? Five? Yeah. There we go, Jim. How old is Jim? He's got to be 30. Yeah. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Jim and Kevin. Happy birthday to you. They're only in their 50s. Yeah. Wish I was in my 50s.
Me too.
Oh, let me see. Oh, the night that Patty Murphy died. Oh, yes. It's a night I'll never forget. Some of the boys got a load of drunk and they ain't been sober yet. Topped the train or so, and they couldn't tell the time. At quarter after two, yeah, they argued it was nine. That's how we show our respect for Patty Murphy. That's how we show our honor and our pride. See, it was a sin and shame they winked at one another, and every drink the place was full the night Pat Murphy died. Well, Mrs. Murphy sat in the corner pouring out her grief. Doyle and the gang came cruising down the street. They went into an empty room and a bottle of whiskey stole. Put that whiskey with the corpse to keep that whiskey cold. That's how we show our respect for Patty Murphy. That's how we show our honor and our pride. See, it was a sin and shame that winked at one another, and every drink the place was full the night Pat Murphy died. At 2 o'clock in the morning, after emptying the jug, Doyle lifted up the ice box lid and he seen poor Matty's mug. They stopped the clock so Mrs. Murphy couldn't tell the time. At quarter after two, well, they argued it was nine. That's how we show our respect for Patty Murphy. That's how we show our honor and our pride. See, it was a sin and shame that winked at one another, and every drink the place was for the night Pat Murphy died. Well, they stopped the hearse on Broad Street outside Sundance Saloon. They staggered in at 8:30 and they stumbled out at noon. They went up to the graveyard so holy and sublime. They found out when they got there, they left the corpse behind. That's how we show our respect for Patty Murphy. That's how we show our honor and our pride. See, it was a sin and shame that winked at one another, and every drink the place was full the night Pat Murphy died. Every drink the place was full the night Pat Murphy died.
Pat Tambor says hi.
Oh, Pat.
How do you know Pat?
Oops.
Huh?
There we go. I think Pat. What's Pat's favorite song there? Is it a Tom Waits?
Well, I was looking at our mutual friends. than Seth, my cousin Brian. Brian Carroll.
Yeah.
And Jimmy Reichelt.
Yeah.
He went to school with my cousin, I bet.
Oh, really? Is that true, Pat?
Brian Carroll. How did we never know that before?
I don't know how we didn't know that. Yeah. But I'd like to get Pat up to sing this song. Well, my time went so quickly, I went lickety-splitly. I to my old 55. As I pulled away slowly, well, I'm feeling so holy. God knows I was feeling alive. And now the sun is coming up, and I'm riding, and I ride with Lady Love. And freeway cars and trucks, hey, stars beginning to fade. As I lead the purple breeze, just to wish it I stayed a little long. Oh Lord, yeah, the feelings get stronger. Well, it's 6 in the morning and you gave me no warning. Well, I had to be on my way. Well, the cars are all passing and the trucks are all flashing. Well, I'm heading home from your place. And the sun is, it's coming up. Well, I'm riding and I ride and I ride with Lady Love. Well, freeway cars and trucks, the stars beginning to fade. As I lead the parade, just a wishing I stayed a little longer. Oh Lord, the feelings get stronger. Yeah, it's 6 in the morning and you gave me no warning. I had to be on my way. Well, the cars are all passing, trucks are all flashing, and I'm heading home from your place. It's coming up. Yeah, I'm riding and I ride and I ride with Lady Love. Oh, freeway cars and trucks, the freeway cars and trucks.
That's a song for our buddy Chris Nell, too, Pat. That's a, and my old buddy Mike Saxinian introduced me to the song back in 1975 out in somewhere in California, wherever Stanford University is. So, Pat, what you got to do if you're still on You got to text Jim Reichel and say, Fitz is doing a song for you. And a song for Denise, too. You love this song. It's an old Michael Murphy song. I don't know where him is. Do you know where your children are? EJ's home. Hello, EJ. Oh, he's up there. It's great to have EJ home. All the little things are getting fixed around the house, you know. Song called Good Time Charlie's Got the Blues, you know. Everybody's gone away. Say they're moving drearily. They say this town will waste your time. I guess they're right, it's wasted mine. Some caught a freight, some caught a plane. Find the sunshine, leave the rain. I'd love to try and settle down, but everybody's leaving town. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good time Charlie's got the blues. You know my heart keeps telling me you're not a kid at 33. Play around, so you lose your wife. You played along, you lose your life. I got some pills to ease the pain. You find the sunshine, leave the rain. I'd love to try and settle down, but everybody's leaving town. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good time Charlie's got the blues. Some gotta win, some gotta lose. Good time Charlie's got the blues. So it is one of those realities, you know, when I'm learning new songs. It's like I'm fitting that time into a pretty busy day, you know, I'm plopping down on the couch. And it's hard sometimes to get all fired up to learn a really, really fast driving song. But I did promise somebody I would do this. I don't do it well. I'm trying to. Called Sitting on the Dock of the Bay. It's an old
JP Fandel. You're
sounding great. Oh, thanks, JP. That's always a good compliment from a very, very accomplished musician. Now I'll probably screw this song up.
Yeah, I'm sitting in the morning sun. I'll be sitting when the evening comes. Yeah, watching the ship roll in. Yeah, I watch them roll away again. Well, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Yeah, sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I left my home in Georgia
and I headed for that Frisco Bay. Man, I got nothing to live for. It seemed like nothing gonna come my way. Well, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay. I watched the tide roll away. Yeah, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Looks like ain't nothing gotta change. Everything still remains the same. Can't do what 10 people tell me to do. So I guess I remain the same. Well, I'm sitting here resting my bones. Well, my loneliness won't leave me alone. Yeah, 10,000 miles I roam just to make this dock my home. Yeah, I'm sitting on the dock of the bay. Watch the tide roll away. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. I was trying to channel my inner Seth there. Seth is like a hell of a whistler. He's one of the few people I know that actually sounds cool when he whistles. All right, let me see. Sometimes songs that I do a lot, sometimes it's just kind of fun to do them differently. Echo, let me see. Put it way up here. Let me see. Pack up all your dishes. Make a note of all good wishes. Say goodbye to the landlord for me. The sons of bitches, they always bore me. Throw away those L.A. papers. Molded box of vanilla wafers. Adios to all this concrete. I'm gonna find me a dirt road back street. If I could just get off of that L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Down the road in a cloud of smoke to some land I ain't bought. If I just get off that L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. It's you old skinny Dennis, the only one I think I will miss. I can hear that old bass singing, sweet and low like a gift you're bringing. Play it for me one more time now. Gotta give it all you can now. I hear every word you're singing. Keep on playing. If I could just get off of that L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Down the road, a cloud of smoke, some land I ain't bought. If I just get off that L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Put the pink slip in the mailbox. Put the key in the old front door lock.
he will find it likely as not, along with all that we have forgot. Oh, Susanna, don't you cry, babe. Love's a gift and it's truly handmade. Don't you think it's time we're leaving? We got something to believe in. If I could just get off of that L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Down the road in this cloud of smoke, some land I ain't bought. If I just get off of that L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught. Oh my gosh, how are you guys doing?
Bummer Emma's not here.
I know it.
But Bob McLaughlin said long shot. It really is a long shot. Pirate looks at 40.
How long is long, Bob?
You don't know what
it is. Come on, Denise.
What? You don't do Jimmy Buffett. You always gripe about Jimmy Buffett.
I'm just jealous.
Alright. Here we go, Bob.
Mother, it's bad. Obviously, I don't know it that well. Mother, mother ocean, I've heard you call. I wanted to sail upon your waters since I was 3 foot tall. You say it all. You say it all. What's the matter, all you? You switch from sails to steam. In your belly you hold the treasures you have owned the same. Most of them dreams. Most of them dreams. Yeah, yes, I am a pirate. 200 years too late. Well, the cannons don't thunder, there's nothing to plunder. I'm an over 40 victim of fate. Life ain't too late. Life ain't too late. Well, I've been drunk now for over 2 weeks. I'm packed up, then I'm running, and I smoke the furies. And gotta stop bitching, gotta go fishing. Down rock bottom again, just a few friends. Just a few friends. Well, I go for younger women, stay with them for a while. Hey, I ran out of ways, they come back someday. Still, they manage to smile. Just takes a while. Just takes a while. Mother, mother ocean, after all these years I found the occupational hazard's been. Occupation's just ain't around. Feel like I drown. Yeah, I feel like I drown. Well, I feel like I drown. I'm gonna head uptown. There you go, Denise. Huh.
Made everybody happy on that one.
It's supposed to make everybody sad, you know?
Hillary and Chris McCoy.
JT. Oh. Let me do one more slow one that I just learned that I... I think Jimmy Buffett does this song, but only because somebody told me he did. I have no idea if he did or not. I learned it as a Tom Rush song. Then
Bob very happy.
Check this song out, Bob. Oh, for all I know, everybody knows the stupid song. I think as a writer, it's like one of the most beautifully written songs on the planet.
Well, if you don't play it, we won't know it.
You know, I was thinking, I was feeling a little bit like Seth, you know, because he's as bad as me sometimes. Sorry. It's called Biloxi Blues, something like that. Down in Biloxi, pretty girls are swimming in the sea. They all look like sisters in the ocean. And the boy fills his pail with salted water. And the storms blow off from all towards New Orleans. Sun shines on Biloxi, the air is filled with vapors from the sea. And the boy digs a pool beside the ocean. He sees creatures from his dreams underwater. And the sun will set from off towards New Orleans. Stars can see Biloxi. The stars can see their faces in the sea. We go in the evenings by the ocean. Yes, we are splashing naked in the water. And the sky is red from off towards New Orleans. Yeah, the sky is red from off toward New Orleans.
Oh, it is not Jimmy Buffett. Does he really do it? Damn. Well, I guess I know more Jimmy Buffett than I thought. I did see Jimmy Buffett in 1977 in Portland, Oregon. It's actually a pretty good concert.
Well, I think it's, Jimmy Buffett didn't write it, but he does it.
No, yeah, it's a Jesse Winchester wrote it.
Yep.
Jesse Winchester, who is like one of the greatest writers of all time. All right. Let me get out of my drop D tuning. Do something with a little bit of spunk. Like I said, I was hanging out with Hat Rack for a little while earlier. Had quite some social distance. But it's fun. I pulled up to his house and he's sitting out back in his old Adirondack chair playing his harmonica. So.
I got the blues when my baby left me by the San Francisco Bay. In an ocean liner gone so far away. It didn't mean to treat her so bad. She was that best girl I ever had. She said goodbye, man, she made me cry. I'm gonna lay down my head and cry. I ain't got a nickel, I ain't got a lousy dime. If she don't come back, I think I'm gonna lose my mind. If she ever come back to stay, it's gonna be another brand new day. I'll be walking with my baby down along the San Francisco Bay. Yeah, sitting there looking out the back door, wondering which way to go. Well, the gal that I'm so crazy about don't want me no more. Well, I ride me a freight train, Lord, I'm feeling blue. I'm gonna ride that train to the end of the line. Always thinking about you. Meanwhile, some other city just about to go insane. When I thought I heard my baby call the way she used to call my name. And if she ever come back to stay, it's gonna be another brand new day.
I've been walking with my baby down along to San Francisco. Walking with my baby down along to San Francisco. Walking with my baby down along to San Francisco Bay. Of course, it would have been a lot more fun with Hat Rack and Seth banging around there. Every week I make like these little vows that, you know, I'm like, all right, I'm going to do at least one Irish song, or at least a few Irish songs, a few old folk songs, a couple modern ones. But I like the way it kind of organically just sort of happens. But
JP Vandellis asking if you know Banana Republics and Steve Goodman.
Oh, no. God, I love Steve Goodman, though. That'd be a good one to learn. Stevie Goodman, Jesse Winchester, John Prine. I mean, they were just a trio of guys that just came up with such great songs. I know, I'll do this little Stevie Goodman song. One thing I really miss nowadays is there's never any freight trains around here, you know. When I was a kid, they always had freight trains going behind White's Pond. And sometimes you'd miss like all of A period at the high school because you were stuck at the Wilson Lumber Company train tracks. Back in the very early 80s, 1980s, I hopped a freight train in Los Angeles and rode it all the way to Texas. When I finally got to Texas, it really wasn't as romantic as I thought it was going to be, you know. Well, I'm riding on the city of New Orleans, Illinois Central Monday morning rail. 15 cars, 15 restless riders, 3 conductors, 25 sacks of mail. They were out in the southbound Odyssey, and the train pulls out of Kankakee, rolls across houses, farms, and fields. Well, passing towns that have no names, freight yards full of old black men, graveyards of rusted automobiles. Singing good morning, America, how are you? Say, don't you know me, I'm your native son. I'm the train that called the city of New Orleans. I'll be gone 500 miles till the day gets done. Playing card games with the old men in the club car. Any a point, no one keeping score. Well, pass the paper bag that holds the bottle. There you feel the wheels rumble beneath the floor. And all the towns and people seem to fade to a bad dream. And the steel rails still ain't heard the news. The conductor sings his song again. The passengers will please refrain. This train's got the disappearing railroad blues. Singing good morning, America, how are you? Say, don't you know me, I'm your native son. I'm the train that called the city of New Orleans. I'll be gone 500 miles the day gets done. Yes, nighttime on the city of New Orleans. Changing cars in Memphis, Tennessee. Well, halfway home, we'll be there by morning. Through the Mississippi darkness, rolling down to the sea. Now the town's people seem to fade to that steel rail still ain't heard the news. The conductor sings a song again. The passenger's gonna please refrain. This train's got the disappearing railroad blues. Singing good night, America, how are you? Say, don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train that called the city of New Orleans. I'll be gone 500 miles the day gets done. Yeah, good night, America, how are you? Say, don't you know me? I'm your native son. I'm the train that called the city of New Orleans. I'll be gone 500 miles the day gets done. I'll be gone 500 miles, living 500 miles, gone 500 miles till the day gets done. No, I know the song. I got a great Irish song for you. This is a song called Arthur McBride. Made famous by a guitarist named Paul Brady, who was like a crazy, crazy good guitar player. If you ever want to hear one of the best guitar players in the world, and this is actually an old folk song that Paul kind of reconditioned and reintroduced. It's about a couple of Irish guys walking on the beach and get met by a British soldier, a few British soldiers, and they try to recruit them into the British Army, telling them what a great career choice it would make. Let me see. Oh, me and me brother, young Arthur McBride, well, as we were walking on down the seaside, I bade what follows and what did betide. It being on Christmas morning, and for recreation they went on a tramp. They met Sergeant Napper and Corporal Vow, and a wee little drummer intending the camp. For the day being pleasant and charming. Well, good morning, the sergeant, he cried. The same to your fellows, oh, he did reply. Intending no harm as we meant to pass by. It being on Christmas morning. Said he, my fine fellows, if you will enlist, 10 guineas of gold I will put in your fist, and a crown in the bargain to shake up the dust, and drink the king's health in the morning. For a soldier he leads a very fine life, he always is blessed with a charming young wife, and he pays all his bills without sorrow or strife, and his days are pleasant and charming. And a soldier he always is decent and clean, in the finest of clothing he's constantly seen. While other poor fellows look dirty and mean, and sip on thin gruel in the morning. Said Arthur, I wouldn't be proud of your clothes, you've only the lend of them as I suppose. And if you dare change them for one night, you know, you'll be sure to be flogged in the morning. And although that we are decent and free, we take great delight in our own company. We have no desire strange faces to see, but your offer is certainly charming. And we have no desire to take your advance, all hazards and dangers we barter on chance. You would have no scruples but to send me to France, where we would be shot in the morning. Hello, no, says the sergeant, I'll have no such chat, and I neither will take it from spalpeen or brat. And if you insult me with one other word, I'll cut off your heads in the morning.
Well, Arthur and I, we soon drew our rods. We scarce gave them time to draw their own blades. When a trusty shillelagh came over their heads and bid them take that as fair warning. And the rusty old rapiers that hung by their side, we flung them as far as we could in the tide. Cried, take them back, devil, said Arthur McBride, and temper your edge in the morning. And the wee little drummer, we flattened his pouch. We made a football of his rowdy dow-dow. We threw it in the tide to toss and to turn, and bade it a tedious returning. And having no money, we made up and crack. We paid no respects to their two bloody backs. We lathered them there like a pair of wet sacks, and left them for dead in the morning. Yeah, me and me brother, young Arthur McBride, as we were walking on down the seaside, it bid what follows and what did betide, it been on Christmas morning. That's a long song.
Paul Griffin.
Yeah.
Was on, and he's saying great playlist. Have you added a Tyler Childers?
I have not done Tyler Childers. I have been listening to Tyler Childers. And like I said in my message, Emma says she's obsessed with Tyler Childers. Has Paul listened to Coulter Wall yet? That's the question. I threw it right back at him. It's a fun thing learning songs, and I could do my kink song. I think I have it down now. You don't think so? I'm reading Walden with my ninth graders at Fenn, and I'm going to sing them this song because there's a whole section in the first part of the book about, you know, our obsession with fashion. Tried this last week. Almost got it down. We'll see. See if I can remember it now. It's hard because Denise is a real Kinks fan. And if you sing a Kinks song incorrectly, it's
blasphemy.
They seek him here, they seek him there. His clothes are loud, but never square. Well, it will make or break him, so he's got to have the best. He's a dedicated follower of fashion. And when he makes his little rounds round the boutiques of London town, well, eagerly pursuing all the latest fads and trends, he's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Oh, yes, he is.
He thinks he is a flower to be looked at. And when he pulls his frilly nylon panties right up tight, he's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, yes, he is.
Oh, yes, he is.
Yes, he is.
Oh, yes, he is.
Yeah, the one thing that he loves, and that is flattery. This pleasure-seeking individual always looks his best. He's a dedicated follower of fashion. They seek him here, they seek him there, on Regent Street or Leicester Square.
And everywhere the Carbonation Army marches on, each one a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, yes, he is. His life revolves around discotheques and parties. What's the line for that one? Life revolves around discotheques and parties. Yeah, this pleasure-seeking individual always looks his best. He's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, yes, he is. Oh, yes, he is. Yes, he is. Oh, yes, he is. He floats from shop to shop just like a butterfly. And in matters of the cloth, he is fickle as can be. He's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, he's a dedicated follower of fashion. Oh, he's a dedicated follower of fashion. Milo was looking at us very strange in that song. Sorry, Milo. Old King song.
Playing. Robert Griffin is on too.
Oh, Robert, how you doing?
Coulter Wall, great recommendation. I'll get my dad listening to him soon.
Yeah, I'll do it. Let me do a Coulter Wall song. Coulter Wall is a young singer, and I got to say that, you know, my own children and Dylan, who actually kind of feels like one of our own children, are always introducing me to new artists that I... This is an old cowboy song, and Coulter Wall's got a voice that's like deeper than Johnny Cash, and before I never realized he's basically a Canadian suburban kid, you know, with a lot of talent and a great voice, and tends to choose great songs to do. But this song's called Bury Me Not on the Lone Prairie. Nice night for harvest moon here. I'll sing it like Coulter Wall. Bury me not on the lone prairie. Once they low and mournfully from the pallid lips of a youth who lay on a dying bed at the close of day. Oh, bury me now, and his voice trailed there. We pay no heed to his dying prayer. A narrow grave, 6x3, we buried him there at the Lone Prairie. Oh, bury him now on the Lone Prairie. Out it out, oh, it's mournfully, and the blizzard beats, and the wind blows free, all over his grave, on the lone prairie. The cowboys now, as they ride the plain, they know the place where his bones are laid. Throw a bunch of roses over his grave and say a quick prayer, a soul to save. That's when a Coulter Wall does that, but it's actually, I think, an old Marty Robbins cowboy song or something.
It sounds a little like that your song.
Oh yeah, I stole the tune. I steal tunes all the time.
Okay then.
My devil song?
Yeah, that one.
Someday I'll do my devil song for you.
It's a favorite of the Tumbling Tumbleweeds.
Oh, that's right. Ooh.
This day of faith. What?
Chris Snell has a request.
Mm-hmm. Wants me to stop.
What?
Wants me to stop.
No, he said if you can play the Concord song and say it is for Olivia and appreciate it.
All right. Some people find my Concord song a little offensive, but you know. All right, this is for Olivia here. Is Olivia from Concord? I wrote this song at when I was in a study hall at Fenn School one day, for any of you Fenn boys out there, you know. And back when I was a shop teacher, and there's really nothing a shop teacher can do in a study hall. And it was a Friday, that Friday afternoon study hall. Mr. Bisco was in the other room being all serious and studious with his kids, and, you know, I was sitting in there singing songs and sharpening whittling knives. And then Jeffrey, I forget his last name, Old Sean, something like that, told me I should write a song about Concord. So
she's not from Concord.
She's not from Concord, all right. Then I won't offend her too much. Unless she's from Weston. Anyway, I wrote this song for the kids. I was singing an old Woody Guthrie talking blues song, so it kind of sounds like a... But if you want to get to Concord, let me tell you what to do. You ride west down old Route 2. Follow yourself a BMW. Find yourself the land of Thoreau. That's Henry. Well, Hank, to those of us that knew him well. Now, Concord ain't a town for rabble-rousing. Pick up trucks or low-cost housing. Look around, you just might see one of them rare minorities. God damn, yeah, I missed him. But on a warm morning, you can hear the sound. They got weed whackers cutting up all around. Alarming news in the local paper. A looming shortage of good landscapers. Plenty of sprinklers, though. But honey, don't drink the Dasani. That's for the rosy. Well, the kids play soccer before they walk. They all hum Mozart before they talk. Intellectual and athletic, but sometimes a bit pathetic. Except for that kid over there. Throws like he's from Revere. You and the Abercrombie, you throw like you're from Weston. Now Concord's rich in history, it's also rich in irony. The rich get rich, the fat get fatter, and they put up signs saying Black Lives Matter. Well damn, put your money where your real estate is, you know. So after all my work, writing the song, the kids didn't really like the song. So they said they wanted like a rap song. They wanted me to take a risk because I would tell them, you know. So I got in my truck and drove up and down Monument Street and saw these signs that said, save our historic town. But got a little closer and the sign said, don't let Federal Express land at Hanscom Air Force Base. I'm like, you gotta be kidding me. I was a little kid, we lived over there on Peter Spring Road, and that was right in the flight path to Hanscom Air Force Base. And it was during the Vietnam War, and every kind of plane you could possibly think of would be landing there, and the ground would be shaking. And you'd hear these planes coming, we'd all get on our bikes, we'd run to the ride to the bottom of Munson Hill, run to the top, stand there with our arms spread wide and our mouths agape, trying to catch the jet fuel that was planes flying about 2 feet over our heads. Anyway, here's my horrible rap song. Well, nothing could be finer than to be in Carolina, except you find yourself in Concord and you hear a low jet liner flying into Hanscom with an irritating sound, and the quality of life is really going down. You get all incensed when they see you being snobby. You use your influence for the governmental lobby. You call Marty Me and says you cannot let him in. Let him land in Boston. Screw the folks in Lynn.
Well, I really do love the town, just can't afford to hang around. Take a walk around, you'll find out just what I am talking about. You be careful out there, driving all these electric cars, can't hear them coming. That's the view from Maynard, Massachusetts. You know, JB, this is a true story. In 1981, I was living in Peking, and the American ambassador asked me and some of the kids I was studying with over in there, Americans, to a Thanksgiving dinner. And I sang Alice's Restaurant at the dinner, and I think it was Ambassador Tuttle, what is his name? He was a little mad at me. But Ambassador Tuttle's wife thought it was a blast and a great song to do. You can get anything you want at Alice's Restaurant. You can get anything you want at Alice's Restaurant. I can only imagine people out there going, no, no. I'll save that for if we're still doing this on Thanksgiving. Geez, that would be right, wouldn't it? Man, that would be crazy. I will do it on Thanksgiving if we're still doing this. I'll do a song for Tom Martin, one of my great friends of all time, and what's been great about this whole live stream thing is it's really made me think a little bit differently about music in a lot of ways. You know, being in a pub, it's always noisy and loud and rowdy most of the time. You know? And this gives me a chance to learn songs just for people. So if you get me a song you really, really want me to learn, just let me know and I will. It's an old song called Vincent. Starry, wrong key, me see. What's the matter, Milo? Huh? Milo's got his star. It's kind of at odds with probably raccoons out on the deck. Yeah, life goes on here. I got a couple of chickens that are sleeping on the back window. They won't go into the coop, so I'm like, all right. I told them it's a very dangerous place for a cute little chicken to be hanging out for the night. Starry, kind of a weird lead into Starry, Starry Night. It's a beautiful song though, so just kind of chill and relax or whatever. Starry, starry night, paint your palette blue and gray. Look out on a summer's day with eyes that know the darkness of my soul. Shadows on the hill, sketch the trees and the daffodils, catch the breeze and winter chills in colors on the snowy linen line. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They did not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now. Starry, starry night, flaming flowers that brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze.
put colors on the snowy linen line. Starry, starry night, flaming flowers brightly blaze, swirling clouds in violet haze are soothed beneath the artist's loving hand. Now I understand what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They did not listen, they did not know how. Perhaps they'll listen now, for they could not love you, though your heart was free. And when no hope was left inside, on that starry, starry night, you took your life as lovers often do. I should have told you, Vincent, life was never meant for one as beautiful as you. Starry, starry night, portraits hung in empty halls, frameless heads on nameless walls, with eyes that see the world and can't forget people that you've met. The ragged man in the ragged clothes, silver thorn on bloody rose, lie crushed and broken on the virgin snow. Now I think I know what you tried to say to me, how you suffered for your sanity, how you tried to set them free. They did not listen, they're not listening still. Perhaps they never will.
Dancing songs. What time do we have now?
It is 9:57.
Oh, you're kidding me. You didn't tell me that.
You didn't ask?
I told the school I'd do this whole big section for Fenn. I kind of did, didn't I? I had some Fenn kids out there. I'll dedicate this song to some of the Fenn boys we've lost too many. Tyler and Nathan and D.A. and Luke, Todd, Nikki, man. It's one of the hard parts of being a teacher is outliving your students doesn't seem like the thing you should do. But this song here is for Luke Rogers, who was an effervescent personality around school and one of my favorite kids on the planet. And Mom and Dad are two of my favorite people on the planet as well. So. It's a song called Waltz and Matilda. It's a song we sing at Fenn. The only song Luke learned when he took guitar with me, and he took guitar with me for about 3 years. So, but he sang it with unmitigated joy. Well, thanks for hanging out tonight, too. Thank you, Denise. Didn't even get to do all my favorite songs, all the songs I learned. Okay.
Hell wants a jolly swagman at camp by a billabong under the shade of the coolabah tree. He sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You come waltzin' Matilda with me. Waltzin' Matilda, waltzin' Matilda. Come waltzin' Matilda with me. He sang as he watched and waited till his billy boiled. You come waltzin' Matilda with me. Well, down come a jumbuck to drink at the billabong. Up jumped the swagman and grabbed him in glee. He sang as he shoved the jumbuck in his tucker bag. You come waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. Come waltzing Matilda with me. Well, who's the jolly jumbuck you got in your tucker bag? You come waltzing Matilda with me. Well, down come a squatch and mounted on a thoroughbred, and up come the troopers, one, two, three. Who's the jolly jumbuck you got in your tucker bag? You come waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, waltzing Matilda. Oh, come a waltzing Matilda with me. Yeah, who's the jolly jumbuck you got in your tucker bag? Come waltzing Matilda with me. Well, up jumped the swagman, sprang into the billabong. You'll never catch me, alive, says he. His ghost may be heard as you pass by the billabong. You come waltzing Matilda with me. Waltzing Matilda, hey, waltzing Matilda. Oh, come waltzing Matilda with me. And his ghost may be heard as you pass by the billabong. Yeah, you come waltzing Matilda with me. All right. Must be after 10 now, huh?
It is. 10:01.
I'll do one last. I gotta do my last song, is all right?
Yep.
Now I got folks from all over the country, all over the world, even, you know, doing a asking me for songs. And somebody asked for this song. It's called Tennessee Waltz. It's a beautiful old Patsy Cline. I think it's one of the first ones to do it. I was waltzing with my sweetheart through the Tennessee Waltz when an old friend I happened to see. I introduced him to my sweetheart, and as they were dancing, well, my friend stole my sweetheart from me. I remember that night in the Tennessee Waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. Well, I lost my little darling the night they were playing. Hey, that beautiful Tennessee Waltz. Yeah, I remember that night in the Tennessee Waltz. Only you know how much I have lost. Well, I lost my little darling the night they were playing. Well, that beautiful Tennessee Waltz. Yes, that beautiful Tennessee Waltz. All right, thanks again. Any of you Fenn guys, maybe I'll see you tomorrow night or Saturday, whatever. At the it's a virtual Fenn alumni reunion or something like that. But we can make every week a reunion here, so that's fun with me too. Okay. Have a great week. Love you guys.